This is such an intriguing race, and then you've got Trump showing up at that event in the first place. He complained at the hostile question. I was, to wake up and see that exchange, I was surprised that Donald Trump would be in that setting at that venue, copping those questions. No criticism of the journalist for asking him, but the Trump campaign, to put Trump in there, they must have thought it was worth the risk, or how does that unfold, James?
This convention, you know, they always ask the nominees from both parties to come and speak to it and sit down with them. So this is nothing new. There's nothing unusual about the Republican candidate going and sitting down for this event. This is a regular thing that happens. You know, that he went, though, I think whether or not you're a Trump fan or not, I think that you got to give him respect for sitting down in a really hostile interview situation, taking questions for quite some time from a very hostile questioner. And let's remember here, Kamala Harris was anointed, essentially, the new candidate here. She hasn't been confirmed yet. That'll happen at the convention, presumably. But she hasn't faced the press at all, you know, and there's an awful lot of questions that she needs to be held to account on, you know, her performance at the border, her performance as a prosecutor, her performance as a senator, and how all of this informs her. Because right now, what the Kamala campaign has done is they've put her in hiding. She's in witness protection. She's going and doing friendly events, rallies and things like that. But they're trying to keep her a blank slate as possible so that everybody just projects what they want onto her. But I don't think they can do that for 100 days, Kieran.
No, they can't. And also the debate situation is going to be absolutely intriguing. I look forward to talking to you about it after those debates happen eventually, because you think they must happen at some point. Just finally on the issue of the swing states and across the board, James, the polling, not unsurprising, has seen a bump for Kamala Harris, but it's a significant one, and the race is competitive again.
The race is competitive again. I mean, Trump still has those swing states. There may be some talk about a vice presidential nominee from Pennsylvania, which might help with that very crucial state with, I think it's 20 electoral votes there. The issue of fracking is going to be huge there, by the way, as it was the last time around in 2020. But, you know, the polls are still narrowly in Donald Trump's favor. I think Nate Silver has him at about 2-1 to win on the current trajectory. So the Kamala bounce was always going to happen. But again, can they maintain this enthusiasm? They're going to need to start to put meat on the bones of what a Harris presidency would look like. And it can't just be, you know, oh, hey, it's a vibe, it's cool, it's progressive, go along with it. You know, they need more than that.
Thanks so much, James. We'll see you next week, and we look forward to the US report Friday night, tomorrow evening, right here on Sky.